السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We present to you lesson number 827 of our daily nasiha and advice. Our topic today is sajda tilawat. In the Quran Sharif, there are sajdas. When we read that verse, then we have to perform that sajda. So why are there sajda tilawat in the noble Quran? Primarily, there are three reasons. Number one, Almighty Allah commands us usjud, perform sajda, and therefore we perform the sajda. Ruku and sajda are solely, only, exclusively for Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. And remember, we cannot make ruku, bowing down, or sajda, prostrating for anybody, any creation. Definitely not permissible in haram. Secondly, what is the ruling regarding sajda tilawat? The Hanafis say it's wajib upon the reciter and the one who hears it and listens to it. And remember, the Shafi'is, Malikis, humbly say sunnah. So if you perform the sajda, you get great reward. And if you don't perform it, then it is sinful. Then there's no sin upon you, according to majority scholars. Hanafis say if a person doesn't perform it at all and passes away, then it's a sin upon him. So therefore, it's best to perform it as soon as possible. Third one is that now which dua should we read in the sajda tilawat? So we say Allahu Akbar and we go into sajda. There are two duas that are mentioned and both are authentic, mentioned in Tirmidhi Sharif. The first dua is Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam read this dua himself. Allahumma aktub li biha indaka ajra. O Almighty Allah, in lieu of the sajda, you grant me reward. So what a beautiful dua. Wada'anni biha wizra. And Ya Allah, in exchange of the sajda, you remove my sins. All of us are sinners. So when we go into sajda, lo and behold, our sins get forgiven. Waj'alha li indaka zukhra. Ya Allah, you make it a reward for me and a treasure for me. Zukhra, a treasure for me, day by you, meaning in the year after. وَتَقَبَّلْهَا مِنِّي كَمَا تَقَبَّلْتَهَا مِنْ أَبْدِكَ دَاوُدْ. And O Allah, that you accept it from me as you accepted it from your servant, beloved servant, Nabi Dawood alayhi salam. His story is mentioned in Surah Swad, Surah number 38. So it shows that that is the dua. And the second dua we should read or learn at least, سَجَدَ وَجْهِي لِلَّذِي خَلَقَهُ. My face made sajda for that supreme being, Allah, who created it. وَشَقَّ سَمْعَهُ وَبَصَرَهُ. And Almighty Allah Jalla Wala blessed me with the faculty of hearing and seeing. بِحَوْلِهِ وَقُوَّتِهِ. With his might and his power. So these are the two sunnah duas. If one reads Subhana Rabbi al-A'la, so that also will suffice, but better to read the sunnah duas for sajda tilawat. How many sajdas are there in the noble Quran? Four schools, everybody got different verdict. Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal says one should perform all 15 sajda tilawat. So there are 15 sajdas in the noble Quran, sajda tilawat. Hanafi say 14. Hanafi say we should leave out the second one in Surah Hajj. Regarding that, Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Fuddilat Suratul Hajj. Fuddilat Suratul Hajj bi sajdatain. It's the only surah that has got two sajda tilawat, Surah Hajj, Surah number 22. So anyway, we should try and understand that there are 15 sajda tilawat. The Hanbali say all 15, Hanafi say 14, they omit the second one in Surah Hajj. And then the Shafi say 14, but they omit the one in Surah Swad. So the one I was speaking about just now of Nabi Dawood alayhi salam, they say that is sajda shukr. And then the Malikis, they say 11 sajda tilawat. And that is that they leave out the second one of Surah Hajj like the Hanafis, and the last three they leave out Surah Wal-Najmi, Idha Sama'un Shaqqat, the sajda there, and Iqra Bismi, the sajda there. So that is the Maliki school. But whoever we are following, the Imam, whether it's Hanafi, Shafi, Maliki, remember when he goes into sajda, you go into sajda. Then not that you don't go into sajda. sajda, there's no problem, you follow the imam. So try and perform your sajda tilawat as soon as possible. Allah loves the sajda. Barakallahu feek. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.